Hi, adaptive lovers. Today you're going to learn how to build a basic prepaid model leveraging model sheets. We're going to also write all the formulas on the back end that drives the calculations. So this is the kind of sheet that we're going to build today. You're going to pick your level, your GL account, a supplier, maybe input a brief description of your contract, as well as the start and end dates. We're going to display what's the term, what's the total prepaid amount, as well as the monthly cost, and then if you want to renew it or not using a toggle. All right, let's build it. Click on Menu, Modeling, Level Assign Sheets, and let's build a new sheet. It's going to be a model sheet. And we're going to build it from a blank model sheet. Click Next. And let's build first the columns that we need. So let's assume we're going to use it for all of our levels. And now let's add all the columns that we need here. So we're going to need a GL account, which is a dimension. It's not your general ledger accounts. You have to create a dimension that has the list of the GL accounts that you want to use in that prepaid model. After that, let's add a supplier. We can also add a description column. We're going to add as well the start and the end dates of your contract. You need to input your total contract amount. And then a column to indicate whether you want to renew it or not. We don't want to have it as a checkbox, so let's make it a toggle. Hit save. Perfect. Now let's see how the sheet looks like. So let's go to our sheets. Prepaid example. All right, so here is our sheet. It's empty for now, so let's add a quick row as an example. Let's say we're going to add some cloud services costs under your IT department. Let's pick the supplier, a brief description, start and end dates of your contract, and the total prepaid amount, for example, and whether you want it to be renewed or not. Hit save. So right now, there are no formulas on the back end. We're going to build what's the term between your start and your end date, what is the monthly cost, and that's the one that we're going to push to your GL. To build the formula, so go back to the builder of your sheet. And now let's go to model account, and we're going to add them here. So prepaid amount is your input column. Make sure it's a currency because it's not a number. Hit save. And now let's build your partial count. So basically, what's the count of your contract between the start and the end date? It's going to work the same as a headcount, a partial headcount formula. It's going to be a number. And the formula for that is time fraction. So basically, it's going to tell you the fraction of time between your start date column and your end date for that period. Hit save. All right, so now let's see what is the output of that formula. Let's go back to our sheet, right click and select row details. And here we will see that your partial count will start in January when it's the start date of my contract and it's gonna end on December 23. All right, so now we're gonna write the formula that calculates the term of your contract. So how many months between your start and your end date. This formula is a bit funny to write and I will show you how to do it. So for that, we're going to use the partial count that we just wrote. And we basically want to sum what's the count over the entire time span. So let's be large and let's assume, for example, 30 years in the past and 30 years in the future, where we want to fetch that partial count. So the syntax for that is time equals this minus 360 month, and then this plus 160 month. Now hit save. And now if you go back to your sheet and you click on row details, this will give us 24 months. Perfect, yes. So basically it's summing your partial count over the last 30 years and plus 30 years. Okay, next formula is the monthly cost. It's a currency, and I just see I did a typo on my initial balance of prepaid amount. It's PPD and not T. So we're going to fix that later. So the formula here will be your total prepaid amount divided by your term, so number of month. And for any reason, if your term is zero, this formula will return an error. So that's a problem. So to avoid returning that error, I recommend using the DIVF function, which will basically return zero if term, if your denominator is zero, to avoid that error. So now let's go to our sheet. We want to add the term, the number of month, and we also want to add what's the monthly cost. So those will be display columns, and is the formula that we just wrote. So for that, go to your model sheet builder and select display columns and drag your term, for example, after the end date, and your monthly cost after the total prepaid amount. And then we can go to our sheet and hit refresh. And now these two columns are here. Okay, we have three more formulas to write. The next formula will be a Boolean type that will return simply 0 or 1, whether we are renewing or not the contract. Renewal. We're going to simply read that toggle column that we added. So we can either type it here or use the formula assistant if we forgot the code or our column. So here, just select your renew column and add it to your formula. If your toggle has been selected, it's going to show 1. If you haven't selected it, it's going to show 0. As we can see here, it has been selected. It's showing 1. Okay, the next formula will be a partial count, but I want to display a 1 after the renewal. So here is the logic. First, we're going to check if there is a renewal. So our account that we just created equals 1. If there is a renewal, we basically want to take the partial headcount between the start date and no end date because it's going to keep renewing. So to get a blank end date, you can simply use the blank formula of Adaptive. So time fraction, like for our partial headcount, of our start date, no end date, which is, this is how you will write it, for the current evaluated period. Else, there is no renewal, and in that case, we just want to use our original partial account. So for that, you can select here, calculated account, and just select your partial account. And now close the parenthesis of your if statement. The last formula will be the total we want to push to the income statement. So I like to call them 2IS, monthly prepaid. All right, so here, make sure it's a currency. And here the formula will be taking our partial count, including the renewal, times the monthly cost. Let's use the formula assistant. So it's our calculated accounts. So we're going to take our partial count, including renewals, times the monthly cost. Let's see the output. So we can see that the contract will cost us $10,000 per month. And as the contract is renewed, it's going to continue for future periods. And now let's link it to our GL account. So for that, go to the menu, Modeling, General Ledger Accounts. You're going to click here on Link. Before linking, make sure you don't have any hard-coded inputs or formulas in that account that are used in log versions, because linking it will wipe those entries. Okay, so let's find our model, prepaid model. Now let's select our output formula, and we want to make sure that we're filtering on the GL dimension of that same name. Now let's go to our income statement, and let's see that this number is flowing in there. So let's refresh, and we can see those 10,000 happening every month. See, it's not that hard. So if you need any help or you have any questions, please feel free to reach out. Our email is adaptive@cubicsanalytics.com. And please make sure to check our Adaptive Corner blog on cubicsanalytics.com.